What's going on with Ashanti?
Ashanti's great. You know what I'm saying? She's got a new show she's working on. Fuse coming out and stuff like that. Shout out to her.
Shout out to her.
New music and all that. She's sexy too.
She is.
Yes, sir.
That's a good friend.
Great friend.
Great friend.
Yes, sir.
I like the smile on your face when you say that. That says a lot.
She does it.
She does it.
She does it.
She does it for you?
She does it. Yo, what up? It's your man Nelly. You checking out Thisis50.com. Watch me. She got that fire, crack a fire flame. Mary got that ice cream. All I want to do is
make her clean. Put her on the table. Take her about that label. Hey, what's going on? It's your girl, Jaheim Medina for Thisis50.com, and I'm hanging out with Nelly. What's going on?
What's happening, sweetheart?
Yeah, man, it's good to see you. You look good.
Thank you. You too.
Oh, thank you. You got a brand new single out with Chris Brown. Yeah. Pretty dope. I heard it. What was the whole vibe working with Chris Brown? Was that something that you, when you knew you was making this record, were you like, I need Chris Brown on this?
Well, but when we were done making the record, you know, I went in with the Internz.
Okay.
Obviously, some dope producers. They got a great sound right now. They did Cake for Rihanna, they did Ass for Big Sean. When you have a producer or producers that's hot, it's all similar, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like you know, I remember when JD was, you know, is on point with doing his snap, you know what I'm saying? He came up with it, and we was just like, when I was finished, it was like, yo, we need to get Chris on this. I think it'd be dope.
What you thought about the whole situation with him and Drake throwing bottles in the club? I mean, like, Chris Brown is like our brand new bad boy of R&B. What's going on? He really is.
I don't know, man. You know, it is what it is. Until you know the full story and all of that, you know, it's nevertheless, you know, Drake is a phenomenal artist.
Yeah.
He's a cool dude. He's a great dude. Obviously, again, you know how I feel about Chris. So, you know, I wasn't there, so I can't
Any other features on the album? I know you got Chris.
You know, Chris, Trey Songz. Not a whole lot of features on this album. I definitely didn't want to be outdone on my album as far as, you know, more people got verses than I got verses. My man Akon is on this joint.
Awesome.
Make sure I say that. I also got my family, you know, St. Lunatics. They scattered all over that piece. And I got some more people definitely in the works.
You got a lot going on right now, specifically with this new show you got on the CW, The Next.
It is a music show.
Okay.
These artists that we're working with, these are artists that deserve to be on this show. It's not like we're discovering them. A lot of these artists have several million views already online.
Right.
They have a great online presence. They may have a great hometown presence.
Okay.
They may perform all over their town. We have 72 hours from the time we meet them to the time that they take the stage for perhaps the biggest performance of their lives thus far.
That's dope.
We try to encourage them to, you know, get over certain things, whatever aspect that they feel has been holding them back and not being able to get there. In 72 hours, if they have to go to work, we may go there with them.
Oh, wow.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
If they're mow the lawn,
yeah, they're
you're
with
out
them.
There with them. Okay. You know what I'm saying?
With what, over 21 million sold in the U.S., I think you're quite qualified to mentor somebody.
Thank you, sweetheart.
I'm saying, you know, just throwing it out there in case they didn't know. What's going on with you as far as music goes right now?
Finishing up my seventh album. It's called M.O.
Okay.
You know, it's been 13 years. A lot of them great. Some of them like, what the hell? You know what I'm saying?
Mostly good.
Mostly good. Mostly good. And I'm not just talking about music in general when I say the ups and the downs. I'm talking about life in general. I think you have to, you know, find that line that works for you.
Right.
You know, you have your core base fans that want you to do what they have come to love of you.
Mm.
But you're also trying to expand and get new fans. And where music is at, new fans want where music is at a lot of times. So it's a fine line. Some artists manage to grasp it, some artists come up with it, and some artists don't. That's why it's called a career. So I've been real fortunate to have a music career, not a music run.
Be clear.
You know?
When you started, you kind of brought a change to it. You know what I mean? You had that, you know, really upbeat. It was, you know, like just good music. In the club on a late night, feeling right, looking, trying to spot something real nice. In comparison to the more grungy, you know, hip hop, and then now it's kind
of. I'm a fan of grungy hip hop.
We all are, aren't we?
Like, that's what I'm saying. So we should all celebrate it.
Yeah.
You know, hip hop was created for the youth, by the youth.
Yeah.
But somehow you start getting the older guys trying to control it and say what it is and what it shouldn't be. You know, and now I'm one of the older guys, so I don't want to be hypocritical and say I should be judging it. You got to let things take shape. Hip-hop is a young man's game at certain points.
You know, there's newcomers now, like, for instance, Frank Ocean, who just recently decided to, you know, come out and you know, come out of the closet, really. What's your take on that, just in the direction that it's going right now?
I can't understand that people are surprised.
Who cares?
It's 2012, you know. I'm not going to say I condemn it or I condone it. I'm just saying, why are we surprised? Dude got fans. He got fans.
He does.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. That's what I'm saying. If he got fans, he got fans. They like his music. I'm not concerned about trying to tell his fans that they shouldn't be supporting him.
Right.
That's whack as shit. You know what I'm saying? So my whole thing is just like, yo, man, congratulations, pimp. It worked for you.
What else do you have going on, Nelly the businessman? I know you got, you know, Apple Bottoms or something.
I just opened a school.
Really? Tell us a little bit about that.
I just opened a school. It's called EI, Extreme Institute. I partnered up with a trade school by the name of Vatterot and a young lady by the name of Miss Pam Bell, who's the CEO of Vatterot. She had a dream also. And it come to find out her dream has been my dream. So we came together and, you know, for trade school, it's one of those 2-year max at the schools where you can go, you become like engineers, electricians, and, you know, cosmetology schools, culinary schools, things like that. So what we did was we figured out how to bring that into this business. Everybody can't afford to go to a 4-year college. People don't have $50,000-$60,000 to do that, but they want to learn how to, you know, produce, mix, master, learn what goes on in the studio. So we built this facility, and it's more or less hands-on. We got a state-of-the-art studio in there, and these kids can come in there and they can learn. As different artists come in and record, they can learn hands-on.
As far as fashion goes, what are you doing with that whole thing? Are you still working on fashion?
Yeah, Apple Bottoms, next year is our whole 10th year anniversary.
Congratulations, man. That's awesome.
That. Thanks. We're one of the few that's still around. We're in the works of possibly the Apple Bottoms reality show.
Wait a minute.
You know what I'm saying?
This sounds a little ratchet, Nelly.
No, not the model search. It's behind the scenes and what goes into creating the line. Yeah, the company and all of that. You know what I'm saying?
There's only one question to ask you.
What's that?
When are you getting married? What? I didn't say a joke. When are you getting married? There's no rush.
Knows?
I'm not rushing you. I'm just curious.
You sure? It sounds like it. Listen, first of all, I take marriage very seriously.
As you should.
No, I don't think. I think in this society right now, the way people talk about it, the way people don't take it as seriously. They're just like, get married then. And they just rush off into stuff. And then why? Because, well, if you don't like it, you can get out of it. Nah, man. If I marry you, you leaving. This is truly
this is forever.
Death do us part.
Because
you going out on a stretcher, you try to leave up
my
out of here. You know what I'm saying?
Forever.
You know, my grandparents spent 61 years together.
Oh, God bless.
You know what I'm saying? Like, well, my grandfather passed last year, but before he passed, they were a couple of months away from his 61st anniversary. They had been together for 60 years, yo. 60 years.
That's amazing.
I don't even know nobody I talked to for 60 days.
So, I mean, when the album drops, we definitely got to get you in studio to talk about it and chop it up as well. So, I mean, you checking out, this is 50.com, your girl, Jaheim and Dina, Nelly, and that's what it is.